lifelong author, I have often drawn inspiration for the more chilling of my tales from my own experiences as a young man living in Louisiana after the Civil War. Oh, but the story of Ezekiel Holloway, that I have not dared tell before now. In October of 1879, Zeke was unmarried and ever the dreamer. Years spent in orphanages had taught him nothing if not self-reliance, but the endless struggle to find employment increasingly took him beyond the outskirts of New Orleans itself, even into the surrounding unfamiliar countryside. So it was that on this particular cold and dreary afternoon, he found himself at a rather remote and mournful estate, inquiring about the position of assistant caretaker.
He certainly looks like a nice young man.
Young beggar, more likely by the looks of him.
Aye, beggar or not, we ain't in no position to be choosy.
Do you think he's ready for something like this?
We'll see how he holds up under fire soon enough, I reckon.
Enough already. Let us introduce ourselves.
Arr, that's gonna leave a mark.
Hurry now. She will be expecting him.
Better.
I told you he'd be on his feet again in no time.
Come, we have done our part for now. She is on her way.
Awakened now from troubled sleep, you find yourself where shadows creep. The mansion hides its history, but solve you will this mystery and find the truth that's buried deep beneath these halls where spirits weep.
Oh, I, child, am Madame Leota, speaker of the spirit world, medium of the mysterious, and seer of things unseen. I know why you're here even better than you do yourself. Assistant caretaker it is, and you are Ezekiel, but you prefer Zeke. We couldn't just have the newspaper ad read, "Wanted, brave soul to rid haunted mansion of evil spirits," now, could we? If we had, you wouldn't be here now, and the fate of this house and all who dwell within it would be sealed forever. This house was once home to many friendly ghosts, but a powerful, evil man named Atticus Thorne has taken over the estate, corrupting the memories of many of the ghosts, and turning others into evil spirits to serve his will. Our beloved mansion has become a dark and foreboding place, and we are now Thorne's prisoners, locked within it. But our hope lies with you, Zeke. We need your help to defeat this evil and to rescue our ghostly friends. An ancient artifact will aid us in this effort. A sacred lantern, known as the Beacon of Souls. It is a source of light and power, and can be used to battle any evil forces we encounter. Unfortunately, Thorne will also be using his dark magic to try and stop us. He'll be creating magical barriers throughout the mansion and twisting the very rooms themselves until we can turn on the lights and undo his spells. Why? Not all of our foes fear the light. It will weaken the lesser evil spirits and force them into hiding. Once found, these shriveled souls can be chased from their hiding places and drawn into the beacon. Here, the soul's corruption will slowly be reversed, returning them to their good and former selves. As the good power of these souls increases in the beacon, their energy will enable us to break down the magical barriers that Thorne has erected. Then, we may gain access to more areas of the mansion. But there is more I have to tell. The primary source of the beacon's power lies in the six sacred gems that adorn it. They are called soul gems. Now, to keep them out of Thorn's hands, I had my ghostly friends hide 5 of them somewhere in the mansion. And the beacon still has 1 soul gem in place. This allows it to function, but very weakly.
Yeah.
So we must find the other 5 to restore its power completely. I'm sorry if you find this confusing, Zeke, but I'm afraid we have little time and much to do. I'll ride along in your satchels, so hold it open and I'll just roll. Wait. You don't need to. Fingerprints! Watch the fingerprints! The light switch is over there. Use the activate button on the switch to light up the room. Uh-oh! Fight off these evil spirits with a rapid shot by pressing the fire button. To attack a specific enemy, hold down the lock-on button. Ah, there we go. Now that the lights are on, you'll be less afraid, and your bravery measure will reflect this. The lights on. Find shriveled souls by searching objects, then pull them into the beacon by holding down the soul collector button. You can find out how many shriveled souls are still hiding in a room by looking at the soul counter. Down on the lower left. To pull more than 1 shriveled soul at a time into the beacon, tap the soul collector button once for each soul before holding it down. Congratulations! You found part of an old death certificate. Collect all the pieces and take them to the proper friendly ghost to earn a reward.
He's coming. I should have listened to the madam. But it's too late now. Much too late for all of us.
Goodness gracious. I ain't never seen a storm like this. Oh.
As we travel through each room in the mansion, the energy of souls long past still lingers. Sometimes, this energy will allow me to communicate with those souls in the afterlife. By channeling them, I may be able to gain hints and clues that will help us in our journey. When the easy way you cannot climb, a crooked path could save you time. Ah, this will save you time later. Activate the grandfather clocks you find throughout the mansion to save your game progress. When the easy way you cannot climb, a crooked path could save you time. Strange device looks like something the Order of Shadows would use, but I don't see how to activate it. Perhaps we'll find a way later.
Ah! one slip and I'm a goner. Guess it's too late. Oh, it's like I've died, and I'm looking down on everything from way up high.
If you want to target an enemy, just hold down the lock-on button. To reach the heights, you'll need a hand. But for applause, first join the band.
Since our defeat. But we do not sleep yet, and the plague has proven quite effective at reducing the Brotherhood's numbers. Folly it was to believe we were no longer a threat and to lower their defenses. For as the shadows crawl eastward from the setting sun, so too does the reach of the Order, extending to encircle the globe.
Completes the duelist's death certificate.
Guys, something's missing. Can we get more cowbell?
Good, good. Now, start with the drum riff again. Let's go from there.
A good tune from a reedless pipe, as good as one played for deaf ears.
I agree. It all sounds better when there's more cowbell.
Okay, let's try this again. This time, try to keep up.
This strange device.
Thank you.
Oh, so he's got you delivering his threats now, eh? What's this? A death certificate? Why, it says here that no good double-crossing backstabber got the best of me. Bull feathers! I'll show him who got the best of whom. Why, I'll bet he's up there right now, camping with a shotgun or worse, trying to get a bead on me. Now that you've gone done lit up my hiding spot. Light makes the shadows deeper, though. Could be anywhere. Speaking of shooting in the dark, I have this. It's one of them soul gem thingamajigs for that there beacon lantern of yours. Here, might bring you better luck than it's bringing me.
Yeah!
Shh! What was that? Oh, he's getting sneaky now, ain't he? Oh, he's here, all right. I can smell his beady little eyes. Best leave now, before the lead starts a-flying.
Oh, wonderful! This soul gem will let you fire power shots to take out stronger enemies. Hold down the fire button to charge it up and release it to shoot. It was in the spring of 1855 when I first came to the mansion. That was shortly after the owners first felt the evil presence here. While the owners were away, I was ambushed by forces greater than mere evil spirits. In the end, Atticus bound me within my own crystal ball, as you see me now. Oh, I shudder to think of the owner's fate. But things will be different this time, child. I promise you that.
Thank you. Suffer anxiety attacks, acute paranoia, always feel like something horrible could leap out at you at any moment. Well then, do I have a tonic?
Thank you. Brotherhood has been wise to keep it hidden from us. In secret it travels, from the mountains of Italy to the valleys of Spain, always just beyond our grasp. But our eyes and ears are everywhere, and the beacon will be found. I will scour the ends of the earth until it is located. So it is written, and so it shall be.
Thank you.
That piece completes the organist death certificate.
Wish for health and happiness, and, many more birthdays to celebrate with all of you.
Me, the Emperor, in danger? I'm afraid you underestimate the loyalty of my subjects.
Thank you.
begin a hunt. Now let me show you how it's done. But you won't bless to me that easily. Before I do, just know I'll be watching you.
You know, I can stand the bats and the rats. I can deal with the spiders. I can even tolerate the evil spirits. And do you know why? Because they do not interrupt me. Give me that death certificate. I don't believe a word of this rubbish. I wouldn't put my music before my own life. That would be, well, never mind. I don't have time for any of this. Do you smell something? There's a peculiar odor lingering about. It's not you, is it? Oh, and speaking of disturbances, take this rock off my precious keys.
Okay, yeah!
You may call it a soul gem, but to me it's just another distraction, and I absolutely must get back to my music. So go on, run along. Shoo, shoo! And get us back our mansion.
Now you can fire ultra shots and wipe out whole groups of enemies. Charge the beacon past the power shot and release it to shoot. In part, our situation here in the mansion benefits from understanding the beacon itself and its origins. The monks created it to ensnare and purify evil spirits for guidance to the afterlife. But in the wrong hands, it could be used to harm good spirits and cast them into the fiery depths of the afterdeath. Forming the Brotherhood of the Soul, they vowed to protect the beacon and the balance of the spirit world from the Order of Shadows ever after. To turn any cranks we come across, you'll need to press and hold activate.
Thank you.
bad news is that nobody is alive to appreciate it.
Hey, I'm talking here. Look, I need you to the other three members of my quartet. When you find them, be sure and wake them up for me. And stay away from the wannabes. They'll just mess everything up. Guy, you'll have to start over. Zeke.
Spectacular! With that piece, the beheaded knight's death certificate is now complete.
Pursuit of the beacon continues. In the meantime, I've taken steps to make the order more efficient, given the inconvenience of the Inquisition. Those who did not share my vision for the future are no longer with us. But with the wisdom contained in our ancient texts, I will replenish our numbers with a legion like nothing mortal men have ever seen.
Here's a little free advice. If you're thinking of being mummified, insist they use the softer cotton wraps to minimize chafing.
It may cost you an arm and a leg, but hey, less to wrap.
Don't worry, sir. I'll have the hearse waiting right here.
Folks, get up and walk out of here.
Hey there, fella. Could you use a little company? Well, I sure wouldn't want to be going in there alone if I were you.
Going my way?
Thank you.
Ugly pets, but they are very loyal.
Again, young Holloway. But where have you been? Is this some kind of a ride to you? What's this? I see. Right. Did you think that I needed a reminder or something? I may have lost my head, lad, but I have not lost my mind. However, any warrior who goes beyond the call of duty on the field of battle deserves to be recognized for his efforts. Therefore, Ezekiel Holloway, for showing great bravery in bringing me this death certificate, I hereby declare you a, squire! Yes, squire! Speaking of battle, I have something for your arsenal. Madame Leota had me hide one of the, where did I put it? Here it is! Amazing it is, the power contained in these little soul gems. Well, carry on now. You may have won a few battles, lad, but in case you hadn't noticed, we are still at war. Ha ha ha!
This new soul gem will increase the power of your rapid shots and let you do a better job blasting those enemies. This will come in handy as we continue on.
Thank you.
I think it's time to let you know what we're up against, Zeke. Our enemy is none other than the Grand Master of the Order of Shadows, Atticus Thorne. He has survived for centuries beyond his natural life by devouring the very souls he bends to his will. Though not as powerful as he was in life, he is growing stronger and has amassed a legion of evil spirits and followers to help him achieve his ultimate goal, the utter annihilation of the afterlife. Unfortunately, the hopes of the Brotherhood have all but died with the owners of the mansion and my own imprisonment. This is why we need your help, Zeke. We cannot let Thorne succeed.
Remnants of the Brotherhood have acquired an estate on the outskirts of the fever-racked bayous of Louisiana and have hidden it within. However, my scouts have sensed a powerful aura within the mansion that I will have to overcome. Though I cannot be sure, there is something familiar about this aura.
Thank you. Violets are blue. No matter how long, I'll wait here for you.
How's my favorite nephew? Come give on to your nice big hug. Why aren't you wearing the sweater I made you?
To the opera singer's death certificate.
Bye.
hurt me.
You don't know how wonderful it is to have the lights on again in here. Oh, and to feel safe enough to enjoy it. Thank you very much. Bravo! Bravo! For me? How delightful! Why, what on earth could it be? My death certificate. See? That is precisely why I shouldn't sing anymore. Want to bring the whole house down upon... I guess I did bring the house down, didn't I? Oh, my! Oh, I almost forgot. I have something for you. It's a soul gem.
Yes!
Yeah. I used to have a pair of earrings like that. Oh, how they sparkled. What I wouldn't give to be in the spotlight again, being showered with roses, the roar of the applause, the dinner parties. Filet mignon. Cheesecake, pressed duck, and the pork chop sandwiches! Oh, the pork chop sandwiches.
With this soul gem, you'll be able to fire improved power shots against those tougher enemies. Charge it up and release it to shoot. I'm sure you've wondered how I came to know so much about everything, right? Well, early in life, I discovered I had a gift for communicating with the spirit world. One day, the Order of Shadows learned of my talents, and I was tricked into joining them. They told me they could increase my abilities. Huh. Fortunately, I was rescued by monks and awakened to the Order's true evil nature. From then on, I vowed to use my abilities to aid the cause of good and join the Brotherhood. So you see, aside from being trapped in this crystal ball, I have a little score to settle with one Atticus Thorn.
Thank you.
Wait. Something's not right. Run, Zeke! Run as fast as you can! Turn left! Right, Zeke! Turn right! Turn left! Left, Zeke, left! Right, Zeke, turn right, turn left. Turn right. Sorry, wrong turn. My mistake.
Trust me, Sonny. I may be stupid, but I'm not as old as I look. I may be old, but I'm not as stupid as I look.
Thank you.
With that piece, we completed the old lady's death certificate.
It is the fortune teller who has been thwarting my minions at the mansion. How ironic that she now stands between me and my acquisition of the beacon. She may be able to handle the lesser evil spirits, but she will not fare so well when I unleash the others. With the chaos of the war and the city in flames, I'm afraid the secluded estate is no place for a lady to be alone. Can't you at least have some dignity?
In this part of the mansion. Oh, did I see another rat? Oh, the whole mansion is overrun with these pesky critters, it seems. Oh, would you like a nice cup of tea, love? No? Well, what do we have here? Oh, my death certificate! Well, I'll be. It says here that... You know, I thought this tea tasted a little odd. Here, tell me, what do you think? Oh, no! I guess you wouldn't want to do that now, would you, love? Well, thank you so much for bringing that to me. Oh, rat poison, who'd have thought it? Oh, well, I guess whatever doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Oh, and I have something that may be of use to you, love. I kept it as safe and hidden as I could, but you're the one who needs it now. Anyway, don't let me keep you. You're quite welcome to it. Care for some tea before you leave? I can put extra sugar in it to kill the aftertaste. No?
Now we're ready for anything! With this enhanced ultra shot, you can destroy even more enemies! Charge past the power shot and release it to shoot.
Thank you.
The fever has returned and claimed some of the laborers, but not before they completed their task. Recovery of the beacon's soul gems is now imperative, as is the gathering of the final ingredients. The gems were scattered in an attempt to thwart me. My minions still have not been able to deliver them. Perhaps there is another way.
Completed the pirate's death certificate.
Good morning, maybe evening. Whichever it is, matey. I was starting to think maybe you wasn't going to make it this far. Bah ha ha ha! Oh, now what's this? Arr,
My death certificate. Yes, this is how I lost me treasure. A mutiny it were, a bunch of whiners. I always gave them a fair share. Say, matey, you found any of me lost treasure yourself? No? Well, if you do, you go ahead and keep half, which is 40%, you know. And just to show I'm a man of me word, I'll give you this here ring. It's a signet ring. Belonged to a member of that Order of Shadows, it did. Use it well, and if when
okay.
You come back,
yeah.
I'll cut you in for half the loot. Like I said, a full 30%. In fact, I could always use a good first mate. That is, if you're still in need of gainful employment when this is all over. Keep that in mind. Half of the loot for me first mate, 20%, and not a penny less.
The markings on this ring seem familiar. The foyer. That's it. This ring is the key to the device in the foyer. We must return there.
Good, good. You've brought them to me.
You will never get away with destroying the afterlife as long as we're here, Thorn.
Afterlife, my dear sweet Leota. Think you that my ambitions stop merely at death's door? Oh, no, no, no. Why settle with conquering the realm of the dead when the land of the living is practically within my reach? No more of this confusing life, after death nonsense. I'm afraid from now on, it's just death, death, and more death.
Zeke, the beacon!
I'll be taking that if you don't mind. Your efforts are greatly appreciated, Zeke. You've collected a great deal of souls for me, not to mention all of the legendary soul gems. And thank you, my loyal minions, for giving yourselves willingly to my cause. With the energy of these souls, I will have enough power to bring darkness and decay over the heavens and the earth.
No!
I won't be needing this trinket anymore. Truly, everything that lives dies if you give it enough time. But patience, I'm afraid, is one of the many virtues you'll find that I, well, lack. From the mightiest king to the tiniest sparrow, all will become nothing but ashes, dust, and food for worms. Ah, yes. In the end, the worm conquers all. And my feast has just begun. Oh, I'm afraid your precious beacon is quite powerless without its crystal core.
What are you doing?
The souls, their suffering is beautiful, powerful, but there's still room for at least one more.
Thank you. here.
Phew, doggy. Now that was some shooting.
Zeke?
Ooh, Mustang, the wind knocked right out of his sails.
Oh dear. He's gone.
It was an honor to have served with him.
Bravest fella I ever met.
He did sort of grow on you after a while, poor little beggar.
Zeke!
Oh, we thought we'd lost you.
You were victorious! Atticus Thorn and the Order of Shadows will trouble us no more.
Thanks to you, Zeke, and Madam Leota?
Leota? Madam Leota, are you there?
Woo-hoo! Take that, you bloated sack of souls!
Leota!
What? It's over already? Did we win?
Yes, it's over, and everything's fine. More than fine now. They're free, Leota. The souls. You've freed them all.
With their troubles finally put to rest, the ghosts resolved to haunt the mansion together, for now and ever after. I made up my mind to stay on for a time as caretaker of the estate, and afterwards, with the blessing of Madame Leota and the others, I continued to pursue my dream of becoming a writer. Only many years later did I come to understand how, on that dreary October afternoon when I first opened the door to that haunted mansion, I had opened the door to the rest of my life.